I'm hopeful for this one. I think that this could work out pretty well. Hello and welcome, I'm Tom from FXhome, and today we're going to be looking at the various ways that you can create your own green screen. Green screens are a great asset for filmmakers, and whether you're just starting your filmmaker journey or you're creating content on YouTube, green screens are a great way to just heighten the production value of your content. There are a couple ways that you can create your own green screen, but we've gotten the most low budget popular options that are under $20, and we're going to test them out for you now to see what gives the best chroma key for the lowest budget. Now, to keep this experiment fair, I'm going to be using the same lighting setup for every single technique. If you want to learn what those techniques are, we have a playlist available right up here that has all of our tutorials on green screen lighting. Speaking of fair, if you find this video helpful, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We're going to be kicking off this experiment with craft paper. This is A3 size green card craft paper. Don't know the difference, let me know. This is 50 sheets worth for about $6 to $10, depending on where you go. Or so I'm told, I'm English. This amount isn't going to be able to cover the entire length of a room or anything, but for our setup right now, I think it's going to do a pretty good job. So let's go for it. Here we are with green screen number one. I think it works. From the get-go, it's not exactly the prettiest setup that you could ever have. You are gonna need a fair few in order to fill out a large space. I think I used the majority of my sheets. I only have a couple left. Layering up these different sheets is definitely time consuming, and it's not gonna last for long. That tape is probably gonna give out at any moment. One of the most important things for a green screen is keeping it consistent and smooth. And you'll notice that there are overlapping periods. You know, it's card, it's gonna bend, it's gonna move. I think we're going to face some issues, but let's see what this looks like when we chroma key it. Over to you, future Tom!
Face past me, we're now in HitFilm Express and we're going to look at how to do this. We're going to be using the color difference key. So let's check this out. By going into the keying effects and selecting color difference key, we'll apply this on and automatically it's a bit of a hazy result. We're going to, of course, need to adjust our settings. So in order to see what I'm doing, I am going to enable view matte. Now in this, the black is the area that is being removed. The white is what is being left behind. So you can see that there is some detail being taken away right now. We need to heighten the minimum and lower the max. With any settings, this is always going to take some time to get the right result. After quite a lot of tweaking, this is where we're at right now. The minimum and maximum values are very, very tight. This is something that would be a bit problematic if there were any wrinkles or anything, but at the moment this looks okay. We have some noise in this area, but let's try and neaten that out. And I'll be going into the matte enhancements and then apply a matte cleaner. All we're going to be doing here is just smoothing this out a little bit and then choking it in just to get rid of some of that. You can then smoothen this out as much as you want, but I think that's probably the best result. And finally, a spill removal will get rid of the green that we've subtracted from me. And if I go into the options tab and then set this to checkable background, you can see that this is the area that we've now subtracted, which is a pretty good result. We do have a little bit of noise going on around the edges of my hair and the edges of the frame, but with a touch more neatening around the edges with matte cleaning and a light wrap, this has actually given a really good result. I'm very surprised by what I'm seeing right now, considering that this is just from green card. There's nothing special or flashy about it. It is just green paper. Perhaps if we were traveling and needed to make something for a office suite or a Zoom call, perhaps, I think that this is definitely a easy go-to approach. It doesn't cost much, but I would definitely say that this is a one-time use. You're not gonna be wanting this on your wall for very long.
Our next contestant is a plastic tablecloth. This one in particular was actually $2. You can obviously get them for various prices for under $10 at various sizes and materials. We're gonna go with plastic for now because it's also versatile, waterproof, and you'd be able to take this around somewhere. So let's see how this does. That was a lot easier than the craft paper. Initial reactions are, this is actually pretty good. Originally, I was very concerned that it was gonna be too reflective, probably cause a lot more problems, but this actually looks like it could potentially be a winner. If you crafted a PVC stand, you would be able to take this anywhere that you wanted to. It is incredibly thin, and I did have to double it up. There are also a bunch of wrinkles that you're not going to be able to remove without fully tightening it and possibly tearing. I'm hopeful for this one. I think that this could work out pretty well. Let's go over to post-production.
Here we are with test number two, and again, I am actually quite hopeful for how this is going to turn out. So once again, let's go to the color difference key and see where we're getting. View matte. And yeah, that's actually given us a lot better results than what we had with the paper. So this has given a pretty decent result, though there is some detail going on around here and especially around the edges, which is from the reflections that we had. Now to counter this, we can increase the max values to try and get rid of some of that detail, but you can see that's coming out of my shoulders. Some of those reflections have definitely stuck with us and are now going to be brought into the footage, meaning that you'd have to eventually mask around this. It's not a huge problem given that it's only this area, but if this was in any other scenario and moving around, this could be problematic. Once again, this has given a really good result. There's a little bit of wobbling around the edges of my frame, but that's mainly to do with my hair. What we can do is bring that choke in, and after giving it a mask, we have a pretty decent key once again. Considering the price of it, I'm very happy with how this has turned out. I think that this is great. The reflections are definitely something to look out for. This is incredibly effective. I'm very surprised of how good this has turned out.
We have another material based one now, and this is the form of cloth. This is green cloth that was intended to be some form of curtain, but rather than being an odd interior design choice, we're going to use it for a green screen. This was the more expensive of the options that we're going to see today. This was $12 for about 2 meters. This is probably the most common type of green screen to use. I see a lot of student films using this type of material for a green screen. As the heaviest material that we have used today, it is definitely a struggle to get it to stay on the wall. It is definitely the type of material that would need clips and a stand. There's also a lot of creases in here. I don't know whether this material is suitable to be ironed, but that would have to definitely be the case in order to get rid of some of those lines. So I'm worried that there's going to be an excessive amount of masking later when we try and do our chroma. So let's find out.
All right, curtain, let's see if this was worth the hassle. You know the drill by now. Color difference key, view matte, find the right values, adjust the gamma, apply matte cleaner for the edges, smooth them out, choke them in, then finish with a spill removal. At the moment, we haven't found a bad one yet. I am concerned, like the others, that there is a very tight gap between the minimum and maximum values. If there were anything else going on in the scene, then I think that there could be problems. But for the moment, this is really good. Everything that we've seen so far has been effective, which is fantastic.
For our next one, unfortunately, I can't do a time lapse of it because it would take me far too long and probably get quite messy. Our final method is green screen paint. You can pick up a can of green paint at any DIY store. You can find them for about $6 to $25. It depends on what brand and also what size of the canvas you are trying to fill. If you're trying to do an entire wall, you're gonna need more paint. If you're just doing a little area, yeah, not too bad. This is definitely an action for a more permanent situation if you're doing regular content and even trying to do stuff for a studio purpose. And do make sure that you have the owner's permission to start painting the wall before you start painting. Other than the paint drying, you're not going to be facing too much turmoil when it comes to actually coming here and setting up. It is incredibly smooth and easy to do. I've just walked over here, set up my lights, and I'm ready to go. No faffing with anything falling down or being stuck to the wall. This may seem like it's the perfect option, but there are a lot of cons to it. Lighting a wall like this can be quite difficult. As you can see, there is a bit of a vignetting around me from where the light is. Ideally, you need a couple of lights in order to fill this and get an even lighting on the background. On the whole, this is going to give you some great results and also cut out all the maintenance work, so you only have to set it up for one time and it's always going to be there. What's important when painting a green screen though is getting it nice and smooth. Something that we've seen throughout the other examples is if there's texture in there that causes problems, creases, things like that, that's going to cause problems later when you're keying it in post. A nice smooth surface will give you the best results every single time. But don't take my word for it, let's see what happens when we key this in post.
All right, paint. This is going to be an interesting one to see given that it's not a material-based green screen. Let's apply color difference key, and like before, set the view matte so we can see what we're up to, There's a lot going on in there. So let's bring this down, move that up, clean up those edges, choke it in, feather it up, spill remove. And once again, here we are with another working green screen. That means every single green screen that we've tried out today has been effective, meaning that no matter what budget you're working with, you have the ability to get a green screen and craft one of your own. Whether this is going to be for YouTube, streaming, films, you have the ability and tools to create your own green screen. That's right, we've tricked you into learning that anything is possible. And I think that's a lesson that we can all enjoy. What's more likely is that no matter what the material, as long as a green screen is lit right and used correctly, you can get some fantastic results. So get creating.
Well, that's it for our DIY green screens. I really do hope that you found this helpful, but let me ask you, which ones are you going to try out for yourself? Let us know in the comment section down below. Be sure to like this video, subscribe, and we will see you next time.